In this video, we're going to practice eliminating the parameter for some parametric equations. So the directions here are to eliminate the parameter to obtain an equation in x and y. And my parametric equations are defined here. I have x equals e to the 3t and y equals e to the t plus 2, and we're considering t's greater than or equal to 0. So generally, it's going to be more helpful to eliminate the parameter in such a way as to end up with an equation of the form y equals f of x, just because that's a little bit more of a common form to work with. So to do that then, what we're going to do is we're going to start by looking at this x equation and solving this for t. So I have x equals e to the 3t. The first step is going to be to take the natural log of both sides to get rid of that e on the right. So I get the natural log of x equals the natural log of e to the 3t. So that becomes a natural log of x equals 3t. And then to finish off, I'll just divide by 3. So I get t equals the natural log of x over 3. So this is the first step. We've solved for t in one of our parametric equations. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take this expression for t and I'm going to substitute it into my y equation. Okay, so if this was our first step, then we could describe our second step as substituting. Okay, so I have y equals e to the t plus 2. But I just found this expression for t in terms of x. So if I stick that in, I've got e to the natural log of x over 3 plus 2. Okay, so in this case, we can simplify this a little bit. So let's go ahead and work on that. I can write this as 1/3 natural log of x. And the reason I do that is because I am going to now write this as e to the ln x to the 1/3 power. So recall that it's a property of natural logs that you can make a coefficient a power within the natural log. Okay, and then I have my plus 2. And the reason I do this is because now I have this e to the natural log. Those are inverse functions, so they cancel out. And I'm just left with x to the 1/3 plus 2. Or I could write that as the cubed root of x plus 2. So you can see that we've eliminated the parameter. Instead of having x and y both expressed in terms of the parameter t, I just have this relationship between x and y. Now there's actually one more little step we need to do. If I look back at my original problem here, I notice that I'm only considering t values greater than or equal to 0. So I need to take that into account in the x values that this final equation is defined for. So what do I mean by that? So, we know that we only want t's greater than or equal to 0. So what does that tell me about x? So if you recall, our original parametric equation was x equals e to the 3t. So basically, what we want to do is we want to see what this information about t tells us about our x values. So, maybe one way to think about this would be to think about it graphically. So if this is t and this is x, at t equals 0, if I plug in 0 here, I get e to the 0, which is 1. So here's 1, and hopefully we kind of know what exponential functions look like. This is going to look something like this. So then the fact that t is greater than or equal to 0 implies that x is greater than or equal to 1. So we just want to include that little fact in our final answer here. So I'm just going to say for x is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so this is the general process you'll always use to eliminate the parameter if you need to do so. Although we should note that this isn't actually possible for every set of parametric equations.